Bam! Mr. Taru, in this video, we're going to be taking a look at a scenario here of a region R that is enclosed by two functions, and we're going to find arc length. We are going to also find the area between these two curves. In the description, you'll find timestamps to skip ahead to the second part of this video if you so like. It is going to be a calculator-based question. And I also have tons of calculus lessons, so I'll put a link to the all the videos I've done for Calc AB or Calc 1, all the videos I've done for Calc BC or Calc 2, and I'm building up a set of videos for AP Calculus free response style questions to help you prepare for the AP test. I'll also put a link to the APCentral website if you want to download a PDF of old AP questions, the solutions guide, marking schemes, so on and so on. But for now, let's get going. We have R. We're going to let R be the region enclosed by the graphs of y is equal to the natural log of x squared plus 1 and y is equal to 2 times the cosine of x. What is the length of the boundary of this region R? And I went ahead and color-coded it. We've got a blue function here, which is going to be the natural log function. Of course, we understand that the domain is basically all real numbers. You can't take the natural log of a negative number, but x squared plus 1 is always going to be positive, and we have an orange function here for y is equal to 2 cosine of x. Well, if you want to find the length of the boundary, basically the sum of two arc lengths, an arc length for the cosine function, y is equal to cosine of x, and the arc length of the natural log function, we're going to have to find out where do we start and end our what? Our integration, right? We need to know the formula, of course, too. So, in case you forgot, bam! Picture in picture. Arc length of a function, which is a regular function in rectangular format. There's another equation for arc length when your function is described as parametric functions, but we have arc length is equal to the definite integral from a to b of the square root of 1 plus f prime of x squared dx. So this is what we're going to be setting up for these two functions. And when you, I like to just put these into our calculator graph, maybe this y sub 1, y sub 2, get the graph up there on our calculator and just hit second calculate and find this intersection point, which is going to be equal to x is, right off the top of my head, not really, 1.14087... And one of my, in my last AP Calculus training, we were told to tell our students not to round off in the middle of their work, but only round off their final answer to three decimal places. Now, if you were doing this question by hand, you probably maybe wouldn't take the time to graph it. Of course, it always helps our comprehension of the problem if we can see what's going on. The cosine function is an even function. In other words, f of negative x is equal to f of x. If you plug in opposite numbers and get the same answer from your function, then it is an even function, which means it's symmetric to the y-axis. Same here, if you plug in negative x squared becomes positive x plus 1. So both of these functions would pass this test. Both of these functions are even functions. So when we go to find this answer, this is a calculator-based question. I'm not going to be too concerned about making my work more efficient. I'm just going to type it into the calculator. But if it was a problem I'd have to do by hand, I would definitely want to integrate from 0 to make some integrals from 0 to 1.14087 and then multiply my answer by 2, because the length of this arc is going to be equal to the length of this arc. And if I can use 0 in my integration process, it's probably going to make the math easier or quicker, both, and then just simply double my answer. But we're going to go ahead and we're going to see that this intersection point is that value, and whether we ask the calculator to then find the second intersection point, which is a little bit of work, a little bit of time, or we see that both of these functions are even, this other value is going to be x is equal to negative 1.14087. So not taking advantage of the even nature of these functions, just letting the calculator do all the work, that total length of the boundary is going to be equal to the definite integral from negative 1.14087 1.1487 to 1.14087 of the square root of 1 plus the square root of 1 plus f prime of x squared, not f of x squared. So we're going to take the derivative of the natural log of x squared plus 1, which we of course know is 2x over x squared plus 1. Derivative of the natural log of u is u prime over u. And we're going to add that to the definite integral from negative 1.1487. Now this is the arc length for the natural log between these two values, basically the lower boundary of this region. Now we're going to add it with the arc length of the upper boundary, which is going to be the square root of 1 plus f prime. So the derivative of 2 cosine of x is negative 2 sine of x squared dx. Now, make sure that, I think it's a good idea for the grading of the AP test that you write each of these integrals individually, one for each of the arc lengths. We do have the same lower and upper limits on both of these definite integrals. So you can say, technically, as you type this in the calculator, you could even write it this way, lower and upper limit of this square root plus this square root with your dx. There was a previous, one of the old AP questions where they were asking us to find the area between two curves, where those two curves intersected in a couple of places, and they were looking on the marking scheme for you to set up a definite integral from A to B correctly with the upper function minus the lower function, so you get that positive area, and then from B to C, where again you have to do the proper upper function minus the lower function, so you get that correct area. Now, if you're really handy with your calculator, you could type in the definite integral from A to C and just wrap the difference of those two functions in absolute values and get the answer really more efficiently. But you didn't get all the points on the AP marking scheme because you didn't recognize that you really had to look for each of those intersection points. And truly, unless you want to take advantage of that absolute value function of your calculator, recognize that you needed multiple integrals to find the total area bound between those two curves. That's why I think it's a good idea to write it so you have the arc length given by the natural log function and the arc length given by the cosine, the y equals 2 cosine of x, even though their upper and lower limits are the same. Now, right off the top of my head, that total length of the boundary around the area is approximately equal to, off your calculator, 6.2818. And if you, is it still on the calculator? Yes. If you want to go ahead and find the area of this region as a second bonus part of this video, it's really a calculus AB concept near the end of Calc AB. Here we can take advantage, let's go ahead and take advantage, well we could before too, but let's go ahead and take advantage of the fact that both of these functions pass that even test. Again, the f of negative x is equal to f of x. You plug in the opposite of x, you plug in the opposite of x, you get the same answer from both of these functions. The area, I was going to do this in green, the area of that region is equal to 2 times the definite integral from 0 to 1.14087 dot dot dot. Oh, in case I did forget to mention, I'm actually reshooting this scene because I transposed my numbers here and wrote 807. So apologize if this is a repeat. AP does not want you, this is what I was told in my last training, they do not want you to round off these numbers to 3 decimal places after the decimal, 1,000th place, until you're done with your work. Don't round off in the middle. So include a couple of dot, dot, dots there to indicate you're truly not rounding. Of course, you're not going to put in an infinite number of decimals. But anyway, upper boundary of this region is defined by the cosine function, 2 cosine of x, and the lower boundary of this region is defined by the natural log function, so the natural log of x squared plus 1 dx. Of course, your lower boundary is 0 because even functions are symmetric to the y-axis, and in this case, since we're integrating along the x-axis, that means an x value of 0. Let's go ahead and, with our calculator, find out that that area is approximately 2.893. Let's get our calculator out. If you like this video, please hit the like button to help the YouTube algorithms for more people to see this video, and get to grab that calculator and give us some practice, and we'll finish right up. We're going to get these definite integrals typed into the calculator. So of course you're going to hit your second math, go down to where it says the numerical integration function. You're going to type these integrals in. I already have these in here because, well, you probably already know how to do this, but we have a lower limit and upper limit. We're going to type in that integral just the way it looks. And you can put in the two separate integrals. Again, one for the arc length of the natural log function and one more for the length of the function 2, y is equal to the 2 cosine of x, and get your answer of approximately 6.282. But since these integrals do have the same upper and lower limit, you can just put in that square root of 1 plus f prime of x squared for the natural log function and add that with the same 1 plus f prime of x squared for the cosine function. But I do show you that. It's going to give you the same answer in your calculator. If you do recognize that, please make sure that you realize that is dangerous. Now, for the area between those two curves, we're going to go ahead and do 2 times math, numerical integration, the definite integral from 0 to 1.14087 of 2 cosine of x minus the natural log alpha y equals fraction, and we had I'm thinking of the other one, so get out of that. Natural log of x squared plus 1. And we're again integrating here with respect to x. So there you go. I'm Mr. Drew. Bam! Go to your homework.